गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास फाइव स्टूडेंट्स, इन योर मैथ्स क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू रीड टुडे चैप्टर 16. ओके, टुडे वी विल डू चैप्टर 16, लाइंस एंगल्स एंड सर्कल्स. इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द एंगल्स. नाउ व्हाट इज एन एंगल, वी विल डू दैट. सो एन एंगल कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू रेज दैट शेयर the same end point. So what do we see? That the angle, it consists of, it is having two rays, okay, and they have the same end point. As you can see in this, there is ray one, okay, one ray, another ray, ray two, they have a common end point, and the point where the rays intersect is called the vertex. So the ray 1 and ray 2, where they are intersecting or where they are meeting or where they are cutting each other, okay, that is called the vertex. Okay, that is called the vertex of the angle. So this point where the ray 1 and ray 2, they are meeting, that end point is called the vertex. So the two rays are called the sides of the angle. Now this was ray 1, this ray 2. Now this is the vertex and this is called the side. Okay, now in the angle we will call it the sides of the angle, and this is the amount of turn which it has taken and formed the angle. Let us see this in detail. Okay, in the next figure. So parts of an angle, we will do about the parts of the angle. The corner point of an angle is called the vertex. So here you can see the vertex, it is the corner end point, corner point. Okay, the corner, you know what's a corner. So this is the corner of arm one, suppose, and arm two. Okay, and they are meeting and forming a corner, and that is the vertex. And the two straight sides are called arms. So these straight sides, they are called the arms. Now the angle is the amount of turn between each arm. Now what is the angle? The angle is the amount of turn, so it is taking a turn over here, and that is the angle. And it is the angle, the amount of turn taken between the two arms or between the sides of the angle, it forms the angle. Okay, now we will see in this picture and understand it. So in this figure, what do we see? See here, there are two rays or two sides, OA, OB, okay, and it is taking a turn over here, and this is the amount of turn it has taken, and this is called the angle. Okay, this is called angle. So the angle is the amount of turn between the two arms here. And this and this. So that is the amount of turn. That means the angle. If I am drawing from here, then this will be the amount of turn from this side. Okay, this will be the amount of turn between these two. If it is from here, this two. So that will make the angle. We are going to see more angles. So now we are going to read about right angle, acute angle, obtuse angle, and a straight angle. We are going to read about the four types of angles. So what is a right angle? So a right angle is 90 degree. So the angle which is formed by 90 degree, that is called a right angle. As you can see in this picture, that these two sides, okay, they are making 90 degree angle. Okay, they are making 90 degree angle, and that makes a right angle. Okay, this makes a right angle. 90 degree wherever you will see, right? 90 degree angle, that will make your right angle. So right angle consists of 90 degree, as you can see in this protractor. Okay, you in this protractor, when we see, then we are seeing that this forms 90 degree. From here 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and then this comes 90, okay? So this is 90 degree, and that is a right angle. So these are examples of right angles. This one 90 degree, this also 90 degree. Now listen, two lines that meet at a right angle are perpendicular. So now we will understand what is perpendicular. Now this one line and this is another line, and they are meeting each other, and then this line, they meet at 90 degree, so they are perpendicular to each other. Let us understand perpendicular more. So perpendicular means at right angles, okay? Meaning of perpendicular is at right angles. So this line and this line, they are perpendicular to each other. Why? Because they are forming 90 degree. Okay, they are forming 90 degree. A line meeting another at a right angle, okay, at a right angle or 90 degree is said to be perpendicular to it. So a line meeting another at a right angle. So here a line meeting another. So meeting another line we will take from here, okay? Or meeting another at a right angle. At a right angle means at 90 degree is said to be perpendicular. So this line is perpendicular to this. Now if I say this line also, if I bring from here and this line from this side, okay, another line from this side, then what I can say, that from here also this becomes perpendicular, and when we measure, we will get this whole side also 90 degree, and that will be perpendicular to each other. As here in this picture also, in this you can see four parts. Here and here will make 90 degree, okay? Then again this line, when it joins to this line, it will make 90 degree. Again this join to this, going to make 90 degree. This joins to this part, makes 90 degree. So how many right angles are here? There are four right angles, okay? There are four right angles. Now see what happens in this picture. When this boy is keeping his one hands up and another hand straight over like this, he is forming 90 degree. You can also do and check whether you are making 90, your hands make 90 degree or not. Then the angle formed where two perpendicular lines meet, so perpendicular one line there, other line this side meet, it measures 90 degree, okay? It measures 90 degree and forms which type of angle? Forms a right angle, okay? Right angle 90 degrees. Then right angles are right on, okay? Right angles are right on. See here, notice then when you give the thumbs up, it makes right angle. So when you are giving a thumbs up, that makes 90 degree or right angle. So that is called right on. Now we are going to read about another angle, that is acute angle. So what is acute angle? An acute angle is an angle measuring between 0 and 90 degrees. So, an acute angle, it measures between 0 and 90 degrees. That means, if it starts from 0.1 to 89.99, okay? So, that what it will make? The angle in between that, okay, 0.01 or 89.99, when it is going to form any angle, then that will become acute angle. So, in between the angle, in between 0 and 90 degrees, they are going to form acute angles. So, the following angles are all acute angles. How we can say? Because first one you can see 18 degree, second one 45 degree, third one 33 degree, fourth one 88 degree, fifth 22.5 and sixth 7 degree. So, all are less than 90 degree, okay? All are less than 90 degree. So, how and greater than 0 degree. So, what are they going to form? They are going to make acute angles. So, here also you can see this boy. What he is doing? One hand like this and another hand like this. In this way, forming acute angle. And it is less than 90 degree. When it will be straight, okay, when it will be straight, then it will form 90 degree. Then it will form 90 degree. Now, in this, so an angle of less than 90 degree, it forms acute angle. In this picture, you can see this is 90 degree. And then this is 55 degree. And 55 degree is less than 90 degree, okay? 55 degree is less than 90 degree. Then which type of angle this is making? This is making acute angle. Because it is less than 55 is less than 90 degree. So, it makes acute angle. Now, we are going to read about obtuse angle. What are obtuse angles? These are angles that are more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So, the angles which are more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree are called acute angles. So, wait. So, when I'll draw a line perpendicular to this, okay, then this will be my 90 degree or right angle, okay? But what I see over here, that this angle, the turn is crossing 90 degree and ending here. That means this is more than, okay? This angle is more than 90 degree, cross 90 degree here and then gone apart here. So, that is more than 90 degree and it has not touched till here, okay? It has not touched till here. That means this is less than 180 degree, less than 180 degree. So, which type of angle they are going to make? They will make obtuse angle, okay? So, angles more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, they will make obtuse angle. So, obtuse angles are obese angles. So, obese meaning, you know, obese means fat. So, they are fat angles. As you can see the bulging stomach like this. So, they are obese angles. Understood? And they are really fat angles. So, in this picture also the boy, he has changed the position of his hand. Okay? So, you can see. Now, what he has done? One hand this side, another hand this side. And made which type of angle? Obtuse angle. First he had made right angle like this, straight. Then done exercise, made acute angle. Now after that he has changed the position of his hand and made it obtuse angle. Understood? More than 90 degree. This was less than 90 degree. This was 90 degree. Right angle less than 90 degree. That means acute angle. This is right angle. And now more than that, that becomes obtuse angle. So,
an angle greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. Now he has not put his hand straight over here. Okay, if he puts his hand straight over here, then it will become 180 degree. So that makes, till here he has stopped, obtuse angle. Okay. And this picture also, in this picture also 120 degree. So 120 degree, you know that 120, it is greater than 90 degree. So that will make our obtuse angle. This is 90 degree, okay, line is, and more than 90, that is obtuse angle from here to here, 120 degree. So that makes our obtuse angle. Now what we have read? We have read about right angle. So right angle measures exactly 90 degree. Let us recall that. Okay, right angle measures exactly 90 degree. Acute angle measures less than 90 degrees. Okay, obtuse angle measures more than 90 degree. Now real world example of angles. So real world example of angles, that means many things which you see in your home, okay, or anywhere, and that also has angles in them. So let us see this boy putting his hand up and then the side making 90 degree. Very good. Now the chair leg here touching the ground making 90 degree, thumbs up 90 degree. So then the door 90 degree like this straight. Then this fire cabinet, the stool kept over here or touching the ground 90 degree, here also 90 degree. Okay, windows panes 90 degree. So all are right angle example of right angles. Now acute angle, this kitchen tongs less than 90 degree, acute angle. What are kitchen tongs? Your mother, she uses to make rotis, chapatis and all. So that is kitchen tongs. You can see that in your home, that will, when you compare the angle, you will see that it is less than 90 degree, not 90 degree. Now this funnel, okay, 90 degree. Slice of pizza, you cut pizza and try to eat, you will find that this is less than 90 degree, forming acute angle. Then slice of pie, acute angle. This is not thumbs up, okay, finger like this. So this will make acute angle. When I make it straight like this, this will be 90 degree, right angle. I have made it like this, okay. That boy has also made it like this, see, like this. So acute angle, two acute angles, one forming from this and another forming from this. So two acute angles over there. Then the mouth of crocodile opening, crocodile opening the mouth, okay, that also acute angle. Now obtuse angle. So obtuse angles more than 90 degree. This chair rest on this, making obtuse angle more than 90 degree. This girl, obtuse angle more than 90 degree. Spider's web more than 90 degree, obtuse angle. Hand fan, obtuse angle. This also obtuse angle. Angle, obtuse, all are making obtuse angle, that is more than 90 degree. So all forms obtuse angles. So we have seen real world example of 90 degree right angle, then acute angle, and then obtuse angle. Now let us go to another example. So another angle, straight angle. Now we will read about the straight angle. An angle which is equal to 180 degree. So 180 degree. the angle C, 180, you can see we 180 degree. So we can see over here, that is a straight making 180 degree. So that is a straight, as a straight line making a straight angle here from this side to this side. So this arm started from here and ended till here, okay? So that makes your 180 degree. That takes a turn of 180 degree and is called a straight angle. Now straight angle changes the direction to point the opposite way. So we will understand this, okay? Straight angle changes the direction to point the opposite way. So how? Let us understand this. So what happens here? This is the straight angle, okay? So changes to opposite way, what is the meaning of that? Means from this side also 180 degree, from this side also 180 degree. It has changed the, it changes the position, then also it will become 180 degree. That will make a straight angle. Now it measures 180, half a revolution. So half a revolution. So how much is one revolution? One revolution, that means if the turn angle starts from this and takes a complete round, okay, takes a complete round, then it will take, it will make one revolution. You might have studied in your SST that one revolution makes 360 degrees, okay? And 180 is half of 360, okay? 360 when you divide by 2, okay? When you divide by 2, you will find that this becomes 180 degree, okay? 180 degree. So that is half a revolution. Half a revolution how? From here started, ended over here, half. If it was full, then completely it will go from this side. So that is half a revolution or two right angles. Two right angles how? So now cut from here, okay? A perpendicular line draw from here. So what you will see? This is making 90 degree, one right angle. This part is making another right angle. So they will make two right angles. So straight angle has two right angles in them and half of this revolution. It is half of revolution. That is 360. Now come to another page. So that is names of the angles which we have studied. First one, acute angle, 35 degree is less than 90 degree. So that is acute angle. Then right angle, exactly 90 degree. Okay, right angle, exactly 90 degree. So that is right angle. Then obtuse angle, this is 150. That comes in between 90 and 180. That means greater than 90, less than 180. That will form obtuse angle. And exactly 180 degree, that is straight angle. That will form a straight angle. So we have done this. Now, in the previous class, we have read about the line, line segment, ray. Now we have done about the acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle and straight angle. So now let us do some examples related to our book, okay? Questions which are in the book. So in the book, the question which you have is that question this it has been asked that name all the angles, okay, in figure 1, also find by how much is AOB less than a right angle. So let us see that right angle. So if I draw a line from here, okay, draw a line from here and name it suppose S, okay, name it suppose S, and this if it is 50 degree, okay? If it is 50 degree, then I have to find out, and this is complete 90 degree, okay? This is complete 90 degree. Now I have to find out what is the measure of the other angle, okay? The other angle. So now what I can do? For this I will have to find out 90 minus 50 is equal to how much? Is equal to 40. Why? Because this angle I am not knowing. So angles, we can write name all the angles. So name all the angles. First of all, we are going to name all the angles. The first angle will be angle PQR. Okay. First angle is angle, we write like this, okay? Angle PQR together. Then the next angle is SQR. Second one, S, angle SQR. And the third angle is angle PQS. Angle P, Q and S. So three angles are there. Now the measure of angle SQR, we know 50 degree. Angle of PQR is 90 degree. Then angle of SQR we don't know. Okay. PQS we don't know. So how we will find angle PQS? We are going to subtract. Okay, how we will write? Let me show you how to write. Then we will write it like this. This was 50. This is total is 90. So we can write it like this. Angle P Q S is equal to angle P Q R minus angle S Q R. Okay. So what is the value of a PQS? Angle PQS we don't know. So PQR, what is the value of PQR? 90 degree minus 50 degree. Minus 50 degree. So how much it is? Is equal to 90 minus 50 is 40. Okay, let me show you. 90 minus 50 also do and see. 0 minus 0, 0. 9 minus 5, 4. So that becomes your 40 degree. So angle PQS is 40 degree. So this PQS is less than SQR. Okay, less than SQR. So you can do that. Now the next one is name all the angles in the figure 2. So let us see what was figure 2. Wait one second. So the figure 2 is obtuse angle, okay? In figure 2 is obtuse angle, and this is showing one right angle, okay? This is showing one right angle, and then if I take it 110 degree, okay? 110 degree, suppose this is 90 degree, okay? This is a right angle, so this is 90 degree and this is 110 degree. Now what you have to see, that name all the angles. So this angle again, if I write P over here, okay? So name all the angles. So all the angles, how we will name first? We will write angle LMN. First angle is LMN, this one. The next angle is LMP, angle L M P. Then the third angle is P M N. Okay, angle P M N. So naming of angles, the vertex you have to take in between, okay, the vertex, which is the vertex that you have to take in between, then you can see, start from this side also, LMN, you can write MNL also, okay, NML, NML also, but the vertex, the common end point should be in between, and then from both the sides you can name them. Now, so three angles are there. Now, by how much is this greater than 90 degree? So, by how much it is greater than 90 degree, that also you can subtract and find out. So, this is 110. So, 110 minus 90 is 20 degree. So, it is asking that by how much is LMN greater than PMN, okay? So LMN is greater than PMN by how many degrees? So you can write over there that LMN is 110, PMN is 90. So subtract and find out, you will get the answer. Now, how many angles are there in figure? So how many angles we have seen? We have seen that there are three angles. Suppose here also, how many angles we have seen? We have seen three angles, okay, from here, if it is P, how many angles? Three angles have been formed. This is one angle LMN, the other one is LMP, then the third one is PMN, okay. So three angles we have seen. You will write the names also. And if suppose this angle PMN is equal to LMP, okay, is equal to LMP, then what is the measure of P, okay, what is the measure of PQLPOR, okay, then what is the measure of NMP? In the question it is asking that suppose this both are equal, okay, this both are equal, this angle is equal to this angle, LMP is equal to PMN, then what is the value of LMP? And you have been given that the whole angle, measure of the whole angle is suppose 120 degree, okay, measure of L angle LMN is 120 degree and both are equal, this angle is equal to this angle, then what you have to do? So what you will do, that means they have been divided into two halves, okay, both angles are equal, that means they have been divided into two halves, then for that what are you going to do? You will divide the whole angle by two. So we will divide this 120 by 2, angle LMN by 2. So how much we are going to get? We will get 120 divided by 2 is equal to 60 division. Let us divide and see. Okay. 120 divided by 2. 6 2s are 12. Write 6 over here. Oof. Write 6 over here, bring 0 down, okay, so when we bring 0 down, it is not divided, so we write 0 in the quotient, okay, we write 0 in the quotient and that becomes 60, so half of this is 60, so this is the way you are going to solve. So thank you, children.